right, and again, on a climax. On a climax of a phrase, take just a little more time. You know, to just really bring it out. Mm-hmm. You know, we're afraid of taking time. There are the right places to take time. There are right places and there are places that are not so right. You know, I wouldn't call them wrong because sometimes it's a question of taste. But just to give it, you know, just a little bit. So a little bit of that. And maybe a little and there's something also, the four against the three also that creates an agitato, you know, the interdependence of those elements. So that was, you know, that's what I would do, just to bring up, because it's almost like there are two voices. Don't forget it was influenced by Bach, and Bach would do something like that. You know, that there is an line, and there is not just when you have themes, you know, another theme, or, a theme being the imitation of a theme and all of it, but like sometimes there is not running notes, not like this, but there's something, but this is, you know, and that actually echoes a little bit the first prelude. And he does it, I will show this afternoon, he does it in other places, other preludes, that agitato feeling. So it's not exactly the same thing, but this one, but it's a top note. And top notes have a life of their own.